your kitchen remodeling includes new cabinets, you need to measure your kitchen precisely in order for them to fit the space. Don't worry, anyone can take their own measurements if they follow directions. First, gather your materials. To get a perfect fit, you will need accurate measurements, and a steel measuring tape will do just that. You will also need paper and pencil on hand to record your measurements. Next, create your floor plan by drawing a rough outline of your space, including any doors, windows, walkways, and any other openings you have in the room. Label each on your floor plan. Now, it's time to start measuring. Remember to always use inches and measure to the nearest eighth of an inch. Working from left to right or clockwise, measure the full length of each wall, including all windows and doorways. In a kitchen shaped like this one, you will have to measure from this wall to this wall. Now that we have overall measurements, we will go around the room again to measure each segment. Go ahead and take a measurement of the entire pantry wall. Then measure the pantry door. For doors, doorways, and windows, make sure to include the trim or casing in the overall measurements that you record. This means that even though our door measures 24 inches, it's actually 29 inches when you include the trim. Now we measure from the edge of the pantry wall to the back wall. If your kitchen has a window, you will measure from the inside corner of the wall to the edge of the window. Remember, measure all windows from outside trim to outside trim, or the blend. The height of the window is also required, and you will measure from the bottom of the window to the floor. If you have a wall with no windows or doorways, simply measure from the left wall in to the right side where the two walls meet. You will also need to measure the ceiling height. Measure the height in two or three places to compensate for variations. We will finish our measuring project by recording the location and size of our appliances. Make a list and record the width, height, and depth of each. It is also good to record the location of your gas, electric, or plumbing outlets. Any obstruction should be measured and recorded to your floor plan. If your layout includes an island like this one, you need to record the length and width from this countertop, and simply add it on your sketch. Now that you got the basics, you are ready to start measuring your kitchen. Once you completed your sketch, go to our website and click on the link 3D Design and fill out the design request form and attach your sketch. Be sure to attach any photos taken of the existing kitchen as well. Those are a huge help. When complete, submit your design request to our design pros. We'll be in touch shortly. And remember, for any help, call 833-387-2888.